Welcome to Specification 216, Erosion Control Blankets and Turf Reinforcement Mats. This video will give a brief overview of how to use erosion control blankets and turf reinforcement mats, and the benefits and limitations of each erosion control measure. The intention of this video is to help determine whether an erosion control blanket or a turf reinforcement mat is most appropriate to use in a given situation. Please find additional information on erosion control blankets and turf reinforcement mats on CDOT's website. Proper revegetation establishment after road construction is vital to controlling soil erosion and maintaining water quality next to roadways. This video has been made for those individuals and teams who are responsible for designing and reviewing drainage systems for highway construction projects, specifically, stormwater management plan designers and reviewers, region water pollution control managers, and region permanent stabilization subject matter experts, and project engineers and their designees. This video covers two control measures that aid in revegetation: erosion control blankets and turf reinforcement mats. Both can be used as temporary erosion control, but this video focuses on their use as permanent control measures. Stormwater runoff is conveyed through drainage ditches and channels. Vegetation such as grasses, forbs, and shrubs in the channel help to slow the stormwater runoff. Revegetation in drainage channels alone is not designed to reduce peak runoff loads. Therefore, additional control measures are used, such as erosion control blankets and turf reinforcement mats. What are erosion control blankets? Also known as soil retention blankets, are a type of landscape product typically installed as a temporary erosion control measure and used for final stabilization immediately after grading and revegetation activities such as seeding are completed. They are used to stabilize soil and prevent erosion on slopes, banks, and other areas where soil is susceptible to erosion while vegetation becomes established. They consist of layers of fibers and netting that are anchored to the ground and held in place by stakes or other types of fasteners. The use of biodegradable fibers and netting is preferred. Erosion control blankets can be used as interim control measures. This video is focusing on their usage as a permanent control measure. Erosion control blankets are to be used as a permanent control measure. They are not removed as they would be as a temporary control measure. Erosion control blankets work by providing cover to soil and seeds, preventing soil from eroding while seeds germinate, and allowing newly germinated seedlings to take root, begin to grow, and eventually become established. The blankets reduce erosion and evaporation at the soil level, allowing more water to be used by plants. The seedlings grow through the fibers and netting and begin to establish. What are turf reinforcement mats? Turf reinforcement mats are used in conjunction with seeding for final stabilization as permanent solutions in areas where high volume and high velocity stormwater runoff can erode soil within channels and on steep slopes, increasing the potential for erosion. As permanent erosion control, turf reinforcement mats are left in place and are not removed. Turf reinforcement mats are constructed of non-degradable 100% polypropylene, making the product secure and stable for medium to long-term erosion control. The turf reinforcement mats are anchored to the ground and covered with soil, seed, and erosion control blankets. For more information, refer to CDOT Specification Section 216, the M216-1 standard plans, and the manufacturer's cut sheets for guidance in selecting the product that works for your project-specific conditions. And always, work together with your project team. Now we will discuss the benefits of biodegradable and photodegradable erosion control blanket products. CDOT is committed to reducing the use of traditional non-biodegradable plastic products in their operations to minimize impacts on the environment. Products such as biodegradable netting, which can break down more quickly and pose less of a hazard to wildlife, are preferred in many cases. However, it is important to note that not all biodegradable products are created equal, and some, like photodegradable netting, can still pose a hazard to wildlife, and some products that might be biodegradable in more humid climates might not biodegrade as quickly or at all in the dry climate of Colorado. Photodegradable netting, which degrades over time when exposed to light, can still entangle wildlife and create microplastics and nanoplastics that remain in soil and water for an undetermined period of time and are ingested by wildlife. It is important to note that as vegetation covers the photodegradable netting, it blocks the UV light and the netting doesn't degrade. Plastic netting is also a nuisance during mowing operations when it may become tangled in the blades. Let's discuss some advantages of erosion control blankets. Like immediate erosion control. Provides immediate protection from surface erosion. Encourages sheet flow and discourages channelized flow. Decreases scour and channels in low volume flows. Vegetation establishment. Helps soil retain moisture, which improves seed germination rate and protects newly formed plants, short term, to allow for root system to take hold. Water conservation. Helps reduce water runoff, promotes water infiltration, reduces the need for irrigation, and improves water quality since vegetation helps filter pollutants. Cost-effective, lower cost than turf reinforcement mats. Sustainable, natural materials are biodegradable. Let's discuss some advantages of turf reinforcement mats. Like providing good erosion control from surface erosion at the final stabilization stage. Allows for infiltration of stormwater and vegetation establishment. Long life expectancy. Turf reinforcement mats can withstand higher shear stress in channels or slopes and rarely must be replaced. Cost more effective than hard armor such as concrete or riprap and reduces maintenance costs. Customization. Different types and weights of TRM can be used for different ranges of expected shear strength. Some disadvantages of erosion control blankets to consider. Like occasional replacement may be necessary as rocks and debris will create tenting that lift blankets and reduce the contact with soil surface. This allows soil erosion to occur by creating voids where water may begin to channelize moving sediment. Or due to droughts or other factors, the vegetation may not establish during the lifespan of the material. Limited applicability. Generally best used only for smaller areas, less than 1/2 acres. Not for use where soils are not compactable, such as sandy and rocky soils. Biodegradable. Yes, natural netting is biodegradable, but photodegradable netting may not degrade in areas with established vegetation, and polypropylene netting is not biodegradable. Polypropylene netting can contribute to the problem of microplastics and nanoplastics in the environment. Life expectancy. The longevity of most blanket materials is dependent on factors such as rain, wind, freeze-thaw, vegetation density, etc. The material lifespan may be as little as 3 months and as long as 2 years. In Colorado's dry climate, the material may remain for many years before breaking down. Please note that once erosion control blanket is installed, do not seed on top of it because the erosion control blanket doesn't allow for the seed-to-soil contact that is necessary for seed to establish and grow. Seeding must occur prior to the installation of the erosion control blanket. Disadvantages of turf reinforcement mats are material cost. Turf reinforcement mats material and installation costs and are higher than erosion control blankets. Installation can be difficult. Limited vegetation options. TRM cannot be used on slopes or areas where the surface cannot be smoothed out. Rocks larger than 4 inches must be removed as those will cause tenting and the TRM will be ineffective. Not biodegradable. TRM is for long-term permanent use. When it breaks down, it adds to microplastics and nanoplastics in the environment. Best used as the soil-filled TRM application with erosion control blanket on top per M216-1. When seeding in channels where stormwater can move the seed before germination, the erosion control blankets or turf reinforcement mats. Do not use tackifiers in moving water or areas of concentrated flows because tackifiers are water-soluble and will not be effective. Please note that some of these steps may involve some iteration or overlap. Thank you for watching. Please watch our next video.